We're not at the center of ourselves. We're not the ones really driving the ship. Most of what you think and do and believe is generated by parts of your brain that you have no access to. And so the question becomes, what does that mean for us knowing ourselves? Well, what it means is that introspection of knowing yourself just by introspection is pretty poor. And we need to import the tools of science to really understand what's happening there and who we are. But what I argue in the end of the book is that that sort of fall from the center of ourselves is actually quite mind expanding. Exactly like when Galileo discovered that the Earth was not at the center of the universe. Religious critics decried that as a dethronement of man from his position. But what it did is it opened up for us something much bigger and much more wondrous, which was this understanding of the size of the cosmos and the fact that there might be alien life forms, and, you know, really getting this awe and wonder at how vast and subtle and amazing the universe is. And I think that's analogous to what's going to happen in the brain. The more we understand about it, the more we understand how vast and wondrous and subtle the brain is. I don't think most people appreciate exactly what kind of system we found under the hood there. It's the most complicated thing we have ever found in the universe. And yet it is equivalent to us. It's all of your hopes and dreams and aspirations. But we don't have any idea how to build machinery like this. It's sort of an alien kind of computational fabric made of hundreds of billions of miniaturized self-healing parts. And it doesn't have sort of a fixed wiring configuration, but instead it's always rewiring itself. And it's so mind-blowing, this vast, wet, electrochemical system that we call the nervous system. And the really weird part is the most wondrous thing that we've discovered in the universe is us.